Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is DSP News. This will be the second story for today. We're going to do a little bit of a follow-up on the DSP girlfriend situation. Let me clarify a couple things real quick that I may have messed up. I don't remember who sent me the Proto Mario situation or a video, which was pretty funny. I'm not sure if Doom, I don't think Doom, Doom said that he didn't do it. He sent me something else. So I guess I may have scrolled a little bit down and that's where I actually saw it. So my bad on that, Doom. And let me give you guys a little bit of clarification from this morning's video. So as you guys may or may not know, you'll see pictures throughout the this video, as well as there'll be a GTG radio segment also. And a video from Mr. Stuffs. We're just going to go back over the old video and just see if we missed anything. I had said that I had felt a certain type of way about actually doing a video, given some of the new developments in Phil's girlfriend. Now, most of you may have thought I was talking about the picture that is all over Kiwi Forums. Dragon Killer, shouts out to Dragon Killer. He also has it on his Twitter, which you're actually going to see the feed for that. I think most of you guys were talking, thought I may have been speaking about that. I am not. And usually when I'm sent information, it's usually from Doom. There's a couple other people who also send me some stuff. But this person has been sending me stuff on the Ninja for a little while. On the sneak, if you'd like to say. And I don't know exactly who this person is. I'm not going to put their name out there because they asked me not to. But they did send me a picture, to be honest with you, and it's not the one that's circulating. It's something different. It's Phil and somebody else sitting down, but they're not wearing the same stuff. It's on some next level shit. And the story that this person was giving me behind it was, I didn't know what to make of it. So when some of the usual suspects came by here and I was like, yo, this is what I'm looking at. They're like, yeah, you can't put that out there. And whatnot, and they were like, it's probably just a troll, so it may not be anything, but even if it is, you shouldn't do that. And I feel that, first off, you can't even really tell if it's Phil or not. The chick in it is, or the young lady in it, I should say, I'm sorry. The lady in it is, young lady is definitely young. Not like, you know, where we need to call the cops or anything, but she's young. It definitely looks like it could pass by for Leanna, maybe. I do feel like Leanna had some broader shoulders, but it's hard to say. And that, and if that is Phil in this picture, he doesn't look right. So I had originally made the video and I scrapped it and whatnot. I'm going to just put that in the vault and I'm just going to leave it there, as well as all the material that I was sent on it. This happens every once in a while where people just send me some stuff that I was just like, whoa. But this was different because someone took some time to get this particular shot. It wasn't like someone took some time to do it. So it is what it is. To the person who sent it to me, I told you I wasn't sure if I was going to use it or not. So you kind of knew where I was coming from the hop anyway. But I'm going to put it in the vault because I don't like scrapping videos. I just kind of put it in the vault and one day I might drop it. So there you go. So there it is. Now, let's talk about the actual... So I just wanted to clarify that because I know I was kind of rambling about it and it kind of changed my mood a little bit going forward. And I didn't want anybody to assume that, oh, well, did this guy send it to him and what it was? I just want to clarify that because I really appreciate not only the people who send me information, but also the people who actually watch the video. So I want to try to have some transparency with you a little bit more so than what Phil does. Because Phil only gives you as much Phil only lets you see as much as he can profit from you. And even though I'm terrible at my job, which I'm glad because you know, I'm saying I'm supposed to be completely unprofessional in this, I also still want to give you guys a level of transparency. Unless someone acts as, hey, you know, please leave my name out of that, which has happened a couple times, especially with that Brightside Viking situation. That might actually come up later on this evening, or no, I might not be this evening's video. It might be tomorrow's or Sunday's. We'll see. I'm still just making sure I have all my ducks in a row on that because there's some extra stuff in there too that I wasn't really expecting, and I might cut some of that out. So we'll see. Phil's girlfriend. Let's talk about what we do know. Let's talk about what's on Twitter, okay? Dragon Killer, as well as some other gunners up there who have been talking about it. And the video itself actually has, or the photo itself has a little bit of controversy in the fact that was it crossing the line with stalking and whatnot? The picture in question, which, like I said, you'll see throughout the video, I'll sprinkle it in there, shows someone who possibly looks like Phil, as well as a young lady. And they're just walking through the mall chilling for the most part. Now, is it Phil? It could be. Is it Phil recently? I don't think so. But we'll get into that shortly. They're just walking through the mall, nothing serious. Whoever took this shot was probably next to a fountain, was probably standing next to a fountain or something. If you guys have been to the mall, you know how this works. Or they may have been on a bench. It could have been anything. Now, granted, the way the picture is taken, you would think someone's going to pay attention to what's going on there, but maybe not. You know, people take pictures of storefronts a lot. I know that sounds random, but it does. It happens quite a bit. You'd be surprised. I want to say, I can't speak for everybody in the detractor community, but I'm going to be an asshole. I'm going to do it. No one here condones stalking. Whatever dumb shit that Phil does and whatnot, and that's online, I'm going to report on it because it's online. What he does offline is just that, unless he gets dumb and he opens his mouth and then talks about it, which eventually he will. So no one condones stalking. And so I understand where certain people are coming from with, yo, this is starting to get kind of creepy. This is starting to be, you know, this is going overboard. But at the same time, I understand the other half of the argument where the picture's already online. It wasn't, you know, I'm saying it's already online. A few people have it and whatnot, and they're just bringing it to the forefront. So I understand that too. And obviously, I understand that because I'm doing a video on it. So there you go. So I wanted to get that out of the way. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if this picture is real, and this is where things kind of get important, let's talk about that first before we talk about what's bullshit. If this picture is real, if that is Phil, then he's, I don't know. Like I said, it's really a back shot. I'm not seeing no cake back there on her part. I don't know. Maybe she's not doing squats. I don't know. I don't know. You know, but I'm not seeing no cake back there. So I guess it is what it is on that. But she doesn't look, I don't know. She doesn't look terrible. Like her, you know, she doesn't look horrible. You know what I mean? She has an average body type, I guess you could say. Is the dude Phil? It could be. He kind of has that kind of, you know, gout type strut to it. You know what I'm saying? In mid stride. It's hard to say though. I couldn't tell you for sure, but it's possible. Now, if this is like yet again, I'm repeating myself yet again. If this is real, okay, good for him. He ended up locking himself somebody in who is young enough to take care of him in his later years and young enough and in his case for him, I would assume, hopefully pretty enough to where she can get a nice job, where she's a people person, where she has like that kind of glowing smile that will attract people to her, and in turn she'll do well in her employment, which in turn will do well for Phil. Now, sticking to Phil's MO about younger women, this isn't going to work in the long term. Okay, the fact that he ended up getting 5 years out of Leanna is something in itself, but then again, she was inexperienced. Now, I'm not saying that I've spoken to Tyrone or Pedro. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying I may have shot a text message to him. He may have shot a text message back, and he's like, I'm still breaking her in, but you know, she's a work in progress. That's all I've heard. I don't know anything specifically. Okay, that was. that wasn't on the record, ladies and gentlemen. That wasn't on the record. But let's continue. With Phil's MO of going after younger women, maybe he feels this is someone he can control. And for her, I'm not saying that she has any baggage or anything, but maybe she doesn't mind being with an older man. It gives her some experience. Maybe she'll get some life lessons out of it. Who could say? Now, most of you are probably laughing in your seats right now, being like, life lessons. You're funny, GTG. What kind of life lessons is she going to give? Please, and please indulge us in this. Let me allow, humor me for just a second. You have a man who cannot do anything right at all. Even though he was able to snag her, if this picture is real, he hasn't been able to do much in his life right. So all she really has to do is the opposite of what he's doing. Instead of doing what Leanna did, where she tried to engage with Phil, she tried to get in there with him and whatnot, and tried to almost be mentored, which is hence the father-daughter thing that came about, until she ended up getting a job, and then he kind of had to look at her with a certain line of respect. But then, well, we'll get into that. No, let me just go ahead and go with that. Okay, so with Leanna, at first, it was very much, he basically was trying to tutor her, I guess. He was trying to mold her, I should say. And she was young enough and naive enough in some respects that he could do that. The best thing that happened to her was getting a job, because it allowed her to go out of her ecosystem, so to speak, and actually mingle with other people. And actually find herself a little bit. Apparently she met some chicks out there. They went out to the bar a couple times, maybe, or at least went out for coffee and whatnot. And it gave her a chance to kind of find who she was outside of Phil. Because up to that point, Phil defined her as a person, so to speak. Phil sending her out to get a job allowed her to break away in such a way it allowed her a form of independence. That may have been one of the things that made her strong enough to leave. But then again, it's a shame the situation that happened that caused her to leave. She should have been able to leave before that. But that's neither here nor there. That's just my own personal opinion. To where, and in that situation, at least when she was working, Phil, to some degree, had to look at her differently. I can't remember if it was Almighty Tevin or if it was Theo who brought this up, this scenario up. Shouts out to both of them. He had to look at her slightly differently. I can't remember who said it, though, but one of them said he started to look at her like a mother-type figure. I kind of agree with that, but I would like to say she was elevated, certainly. Did he look at her as an equal? No, because he didn't respect her. But he had to take certain things into account with her, because he needed her. You got to understand, this isn't about love, ladies and gentlemen. This comes from a need. This comes from a need that Phil needing to be taken care of by somebody. Typically, and hopefully a female, but I don't know. With Brightside Viking out there, it's whatever. Anyway, it's whatever. But he needs to be taken care of by somebody. And all this young lady now, jumping forward, if she's real, all she's going to do is fill that role. He's going to try to tweak some things, but once he gets comfortable, and once she gets comfortable dealing with him, then that becomes a different story. Now for her, what should she do in this situation? So if you're listening, young lady, I hope you take at least a little bit of this into consideration. Pay attention to what Phil does. Pay attention to his tendencies. Pay attention to how he conducts himself, because that's how you're going to get over if you're trying to get over. And the reason why I say that is because I don't really know what your motivations are. No one does. I think for Leanna, it was love. I know that sounds strange, but I think it was love. I think she really loved him. You, on the other hand, young lady, have an interesting type of stigma around you. It's Phil. What exactly about him what are you attracted to about Phil? Like, what is it that, what animal magnetism that's between the two of you that you feel like, you know what, I can spend time with this person? It's awkward. Now, granted, it's fair to say that everybody should have, there's somebody compatible for everybody. And there's nothing wrong with that. And even Phil deserves someone. I personally would like to see fill with an older woman who can curve him, to be honest with you. One who can bring him to heel. I haven't seen a woman do that yet. And the way he threw his mother under the bus recently, talking about why he has that bald spot, he just doesn't respect anything. An older woman would be able to bring him to heel. A younger woman won't. So either, young lady, and I'm going out on a limb here by saying this to you, you're either A, you're gonna take him for the gusto, or B, this is a troll on fucking KGB type levels. Okay? Where Freddy Boy is ready to lay down his final plot. It has to be something along these lines. Now, obviously, I'm joking about the Freddy Boy part because I assume he would think out something much more elaborate. But what is her motivation? What is it that would make you want to be touched by this man? And if you're a female, you're gonna sleep with this cat. I am astounded. For all of you beautiful, luscious, yummy ladies out there in my audience, I hope there's a few of you. Tell me, please, give me some insight. Give us some insight here at GTG on what this is. Because I'll be honest with you, female friends that I have introduced Phil to in the fact of his videos and whatnot, no. Hell no. Hell no. Those right there are direct quotes. Hell no. There, one of them went so far to say there is not enough money in Saudi Arabia as well as oil to do it. And let's be honest, we all saw that situation on that live stream. He's not gonna last that much. He's not gonna last any more than that. And she still said no. So you ladies tell me in my audience, you beautiful women, you tell me what it is that this young lady may be thinking. Give me something, anything, and I would very much appreciate it. I would very much appreciate it. Give me something, anything. You know what I mean? Just help me understand and whatnot. And yet again, for someone who is on his couch all day, sweating it up, how do you have time to find a woman? How do you have time to find a girlfriend? You do nothing all day, except for bitch and complain and beg for money. How did you find the time? You yourself were saying that, hey, most girls have curfews. Phil himself said most girls have curfews and they're not gonna be out at night. So how did you find her? Did you run out for a DSP transit? You saw her get off the school bus? What happened? Were you in line and you were feeling generous and you decided to buy her a Happy Meal and upgraded her drink into a McFlurry? What happened? Is it possible that you decided to go and eat fresh and she was in line with her older sister and you said, "What's up?" I'm just saying. I'm not trying to bring no Jared shit up. I'm just saying. I need to understand. I just want to understand. In either case, ladies and gentlemen, that's if she's real. Now let's get to the beautiful parts of this. Let's get to the parts that are a bit more plausible. What if she's fake? What if this picture is fake? If the picture is fake, then what I mean by fake, it's an older picture of maybe Phil and Leanna a while back. Now, the thing is this young lady's hair is actually a decent sized length, if I remember correctly. So I don't know. Actually, hold on a second. Let me try to be diligent. Yeah, her hair comes about mid back, to be honest with you. So it would be kind of hard to say if that was her. It's very hard to say. I'm not really quite sure. That's neither here nor there, I guess, really. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what to make of that part. Another thing is it just a clever Photoshop? Maybe. Maybe. It might be. It could be. How was it obtained? You know what I'm saying? Why was someone the coincidence of the convenience, the coincidence and the convenience of it popping up just like that? There's a lot of things that just make it not seem right. One of the things that people point out about it being fake is the woman who's walking with this person doesn't look anything like Leanna. The shoulders aren't right, and they aren't. Phil himself, if that is Phil, this guy's in better shape and no bald spot or no noticeable one. Plus, they pointed out that this guy's pretty much clean shaven. Does he have a gold tee? Maybe, but you don't see it protrude from the sides. So that's another kind of point. Someone pointed out the dirty elbows. I don't know shit about that. we all know Phil don't like taking showers. But if you look at that kind of walk, it's a goutish type walk. Could be possible. It's hard to say. It's too convenient, to be honest with you, given the circumstances. Now, the person on Kiwi Forms who allegedly leaked this picture, as I was going through the forums, I'll have a little bit of it in the video also. People said that it's a fresh account. So it could very well easily be a fake account and whatnot. Someone from King of Hate forums may have jumped over there and did it to create the firestorm. So there you go on that as it pertains to it being fake. There's a bunch of variables in this equation that just doesn't seem right. Now let's talk about how it benefits Phil. Now this is important before we get into the video, into the audio that I need to push this forward. All right, this is gonna be a bit long-winded. Let's go. It benefits Phil for a couple of reasons. Most people would think, oh, well, he'll be able to get more money out of his sympathizers and supporters. But it's a little bit more than that. Bear with me. What this drums up, more than anything else, is attention. It gives Phil attention. And I'm not talking about people who know who Phil is. From people who probably don't even know who Phil is. This drums in a whole new group of people into Phil's web of lies that could potentially be the next generation of people who are going to give him money. Let me give you an example. Phil had a live stream recently, and as you know, he does it in shifts. And he had purposely pointed out that, you know, hey guys, I had talked about this situation in my early stream, and I'm looking at all the people here now, and you guys are obviously a new batch of people, so I'll go ahead and fill you in. Now think about what he said. He says that you guys are a brand new batch of people that weren't here this morning, so allow me to fill you in. Are they the same crowd of people? Obviously not. But what I'm saying is that outside of the usual suspects that probably show up to his afternoon stream, we're also talking about another brand new group of people who are just flushing in to see what this is all about. What he is all about. This could work to his benefit if he plays his cards right. Another thing, to be honest with you, is its cover. It is cover for when he doesn't lose that house. As I've said before, ladies and gentlemen, he has to lose that house to make this worthwhile. If it's true, if his tax situation is true, he's going to lose that house. What she does, and as some of you have pointed out in my comment section, is the girlfriend covers the holes that he can't cover. So let me paint a scenario for you. You can paint it any way you want. There's a bunch of different ways of looking at it. But one of the things is if he does not lose the house, he can say, hey guys, we weren't able to raise up all the money, but my new girlfriend helped out. She was able to take out a loan. She was able to do whatever. And she was able to bring this money together and help me save my house. Sadly, because of the volatility that's around me, or because of the drama, because of the unnecessary attention that she didn't want, even though she wanted you to announce her that she existed, whatever, we decided that we're going to take a break. If he's smart, he'll say they decided to take a break. And then a few months later, behind the scenes, he'll say they broke up. He can't just say, oh, they broke up abruptly. It seems too suspicious. It wouldn't come across right. He should say, that we're taking a break. If he does that, then he can make the lie work. Now, in turn, keep in mind, not only we're talking about, actually, because I just read Doom's post, how Snorpernell may have been wrong. Or was wrong about the about this month's Patreon goal. Phil actually did hit it. Phil had apparently some ninjas that came through in the last minute and pledged. And after they pledged, which, you know, when you pledge a Patreon, they take it right away. They immediately changed their pledge for the following month, which drops it. And Doom has been saying that for the last couple months now, and then how that works. And he also sent me some material that verified all that. So yet again, thank you again, Doom. I appreciate it. So there you go on that. Phil's hit the Patreon goal, which is a shitty goal, by the way. I guess that's the Christmas one. And then we're hearing about this epic goal where he's going to do a redemption run of Metal Gear Solid, what, 2 or 3? Which, I mean, Cruz, Volt Boy, and David Davison, I know there's going to be This Is How You Don't Play Us from the three of those guys. So that should be great. Shouts out to all three of those guys, too. I love all those guys. I love all those guys' work. It's great. So we'll be looking forward to that. What? I mean, so he's going to get his money is the point I'm trying to make. He's hit his Patreon goal. That redemption run for Metal Gear, we'll see how that works, but he'll probably hit that. Plus the fundraiser. He's going to get himself a nice chunk of change out of all this, which it'll be more than enough to cover this tax problem, if there even is a tax problem. Some people debate if that's even true, if that even really happened. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of buildup that goes into these lies that Phil does and these scenarios that he paints, and they're very long-winded. So there's a narrative that it's an easy enough narrative for him to keep up with, but at the same time, it's Phil, so he'll stumble and fall. But it's neither here nor there. Ladies and gentlemen, these are just some of the points that I wanted to bring up as it pertains to these revelations about this picture. Is it real? Is it fake? Is it nothing? Is it us just kind of getting in an uproar? I don't know. My job, as unprofessional as I try to be about it, even though you guys are starting to tell me that I'm appearing to be more professional than I really want to be, I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened, but you guys enjoy it, so I want to keep doing it as long as you guys keep enjoying it. I just don't get it. Is the picture real? Is the picture fake? You guys tell me. Tell me about what do you think about of my scenarios. You tell me what your scenarios are. For the lovely ladies out there, tell me what would it take to make Phil presentable to you. If you have to, is Phil clay? And if he is just clay, can you mold him? By all means. Is he dead weight and you have to scrap him and start all over? By all means. Is he merely just hot dog meat with whatever else get turned into some pork byproduct outside of hot dogs? Because hot dog is pretty much a pork byproduct, unless you're buying all beef ones. You tell me, ladies, you tell me what it takes to make Phil something more than what he is, at least in your individual eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get into the video with Mr. Stuffs. I think I actually found Mr. Stuffs on Twitter today. So I think I'm following him now. So I hope so. Shouts out to Mr. Stuffs. You know how I do. And whatnot. There should be another video following this. I'm not sure if it'll come out tonight or tomorrow. I'm going to try to get this one up for you guys this afternoon. And like I said, I'll have a bunch of material up on your screen. So I hope you guys enjoy that. As well as there'll be some GTG radio at the end. I don't know if you guys are liking it or not. I haven't heard any real complaints. So I'll just keep doing it for right now. So there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, this is DSP News. God damn, I'm talking way too long. This is DSP News. Always late, never breaking, unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG Network and Productions. Here we go.
Now, in addition to that fact, all right, there's another reason why I'm taking this time off in December. In fact, there's been another reason why I've been taking off these periods of time since, you know, the summer at these set intervals. And the reason is because I've been taking that time to spend some time with my girlfriend. And boom, immediately a bomb has been dropped. Everyone's probably like, oh, what the fuck? What? You're doing what with who and how and what's about who's about what? Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I know many of you were surprised when I revealed to you what was going on with me back on Thanksgiving, all right? And you're like, how could Phil have kept that secret for 2.5 months and not talked about it, right? Well, I've had an even better kept secret, all right? I've had an even better kept secret this year, is that basically since the summer, you know, I've been seeing someone on and off, and it's certainly not as frequently as I would like, because as you guys know my work schedule. I work my ass off, all right? And I'm here every single day, which means I get very little free time. The free time I get is in the middle of the night. Sorry. Most girls don't have the middle of the night to do stuff. They're asleep. You know what I mean? So, you know, I've been dating someone for months, actually, and seeing her on and off, and I haven't had any consistent time to really, you know, to spend with her. And it's really these times off that I've been taking, these breaks, where I get to spend some significant time with her. All right.
Now, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, one, yeah, you're right. Most girls aren't going to be out late at night, which is why you shouldn't be going after girls. You should be going after women. Secondly, can you really call this a relationship? Being that you've only seen each other a couple times. That's not really a relationship. Not at all. You know what I'm saying? You guys are kind of just really getting to know each other. But Phil, he sees her as his girlfriend. And as I'll have it in the video also, he's already talking about moving her in, having a second income. It's going to be great, apparently. Is this desperation on Phil's part? And because of this desperation, is this lining Phil up to get finessed later on? For him to get ripped off? For him to get played? Is he going to end up signing the deed over to that house, to this young lady, if she's real? Who could say? DSP News.
And so, this coming break that I have scheduled, I'm going to be doing all kinds of Christmas stuff with my girlfriend, which means putting up the Christmas tree, you know, decorating the house. As you guys know, I've already announced, I'm going to go out and I'm going to be looking for Christmas sweaters and Christmas liquor and all that kind of stuff. All right. So that's real. We're going to be doing all that stuff together. In fact, it was back in October that she was the person who I was going around with to all the Halloween stores, and she helped me pick out my Halloween costume, Ezio Auditore. So, in a lot of ways, I actually owe the great pick of what that costume was to her, because she really helped me out, alright? Now, the one thing that I'm going to say up front, folks, because I know this is a bombshell announcement, oh my god, immediately, you know the people who are watching the stream just for negative reasons, they're running to the fucking internet. They're scouring all, everything. Phil must have shown her in something. Phil must have mentioned her in something. Phil must have done... No. I mean, literally 100%. Okay. I have been leaving this as a secret on purpose. Because I knew that if I did announce it, you know, months and months ago, that it would... Oh, my God. Phil is a girlfriend. You know. The other thing is, you know, she is a person who very much does not want to have a public persona. Now, she knows who I am. She knows I'm a YouTuber. She knows all about me, you know. It's not like this was just someone that I met out of nowhere and she had...
But see, that's what I'm saying, though. Like, she may know about you, but she may not know... She may know of you, but maybe not about you. Because, like I said, what woman would want to deal with you on any type of relationship level? You know what I mean? Like, she has to know and see how you treat your own fan base. These are people who give you money. These are the people who keep you propped up. And she has to know that you treat them like shit. So why would she want to get in a relationship with you? And more importantly, she has to know what happened with the last girlfriend. You know what I mean? The maid that she's about to replace. You know what I mean? The last maid basically made her a great escape while she could. But what about, you know what I'm saying? So why would she put herself through that? It doesn't make any sense, to be honest with you. But that's neither here nor there, I guess. I mean, it's whatever. You know, actually, what this kind of reminds me of, and to be honest with you, if she is real, and if she plays her cards right, it would be, go back to, like, Henry VIII, right? King Henry VIII of England. And would that be wife number two? So let's say Leanna, for example, was Anne Boleyn. And, you know what I mean, she was over-opinionated, so on and so forth, so Phil scrapped her. Phil had her, had that chopped off. But what if this young lady is a bit more crafty, is a bit more smart, or a bit smarter, I should say, and plays her cards right, she could very well be Jane Seymour. I mean, granted, historically speaking, Jane Seymour died in childbirth, or of complications, I should say. But what if she plays her cards right? and is a bit smarter about it and observes Phil, learns his tendencies, and gets it down enough to where she can figure out where to manipulate him and when. That's just a theory I'm throwing out there.
No idea who I was or anything like that. She's very well aware of who I am and all of that. But she does not want to be involved with all the online drama. She has no aspirations to go out and make, you know, a YouTube or channel or a Twitch stream or anything like
that. Now here's another thing. I think Almighty Tevin pointed that out. When he uses the word aspirations, like, it was something that, listening to Almighty Tevin talk about it, it kind of really brought me back. Why would she want to? And what do you, I said in my last video that, yeah, she should go ahead and make herself a YouTube account and then go over there and get you back and go back to Machinima or get signed up with Machinima and then try to get you back in there. But why would she need to? Maybe she has a job. Maybe she has a career. So she wouldn't need any of that dumb shit anyway. What's wrong, Phil? Does she need to have multiple financial streams too to keep everything going? That's what, like, the way he said that, or his wording anyway, it rubs you wrong. And more importantly, it just makes you even more suspicious. Because an older woman probably wouldn't ask for that, or wouldn't want any of that anyway. But a younger woman might. Just something to think about.
That she doesn't want to have a public persona. She very much wants to have her own life outside of being a part of mine, alright? And that's why I have not mentioned anything up to this point, because I literally didn't want any idiot to try to go out there. I mean, just think about, folks. I mean, let's be honest here. Think about my last relationship with Leanne, right? My ex. And how, you know, she did very much have a public persona. Everything she knew, she wanted to do her own YouTube channel. She had her own business online and everything. And just think, even though she never really exposed a lot of private stuff about her life, how much about her family and everything was thrown on the internet just because people could find out, right? I mean, we're at the point where my ex's brother was getting married, and I very really quickly mentioned it in a video or a vlog earlier on in the year, letting everyone know that I might be attending the wedding later in the year, and then I never mentioned it again, all right, because of, you know, reasons, the fact that we were afraid that if we had gone, because that was the year that we had gotten swatted, okay? We were worried that if we went to this freaking wedding, that some asshole would try to swat it, or they would otherwise do something to prank it and ruin this wedding, okay? And that's why we didn't go, and I never mentioned it, all right? I never mentioned it at all. Again, yeah, look what happened. People not only found out the date, the time, the location of the fucking wedding, they publicly posted it on the internet for people to say, oh, go ahead and troll it, and on top of all that, then they spun it to say that I forcibly forced my ex to not attend this wedding so I could stay home and play Fallout 4 and make money. All of that was literally fabricated, right?
Well, you never gave us a really good reason on why she didn't go. Why you didn't go is one thing, fine, but you never gave us a really good reason why you didn't send her. And at the end of the day, you should have sent her, as I've said before. So some of that story just doesn't sound right. Another thing is, yet again, that's your fault. You're the one who put that information out there. You didn't have to say any of that. You really didn't. You're the one who was on Twitter. I think you might have been on Twitter, and you said that, yeah, I'm playing gaming a little bit while I'm in the hotel room, and so, you know, just to buy the time by, I'm going to do some recording and all that. You're the one who sat there and pulled all that information out. It wasn't like you said that in passing. You did that. So, you know, at the end of the day, don't, you know, some people out there trolling, who's really gonna, you know what I'm saying, swat a wedding? You know what I mean? Like, who really would do that? And even all that to get one man? To get one pig roach? Come on, let's be honest. You just didn't want to go, Phil. And that's very obvious that was the case. Yet again, no one would even bring that up if you had sent Leanna, though. If you would have sent her, it'd have been fine. So be honest. You didn't want to go, so she didn't go. Because you didn't want to toss up the money, and you didn't want to have the inconvenience of commuting her to the airport and then bring her home. It is what it is. Whatever.
So just think, based off a tiny bit of little real world knowledge, right? what these fucking sicko people who fuck with me have done in the past. So learning from that past, alright? Learning from that past, I very much learned that this is something that I should keep to myself, alright? However, you know, being that some things have already come to light publicly, alright? The fact that you guys now know about my financial situation with this tax situation, okay? Because I revealed it on Thursday, a lot of questions have arisen. You know, one of the questions is, well, why is Phil taking this time off in December if he knows that he needs to make as much money as possible? And, you know, the answer here, quite frankly, is I already had scheduled this time to be with my girlfriend and do this holiday-themed stuff because there's no other opportunity to do it. You know, as you know, guys, as we get closer to Christmas and everything, everyone gets super busy. I'll be super busy. And incidentally, she's going to be super busy. So, you know, what we decided is let's you know, have a celebration earlier on in the month when both of us would have time to do it. And I actually scheduled it for this 1 week when there's no new releases. So it's perfect. Okay.
Except the fact that you end up getting caught for tax evasion. Excuse me. If you guys are really in this relationship, right? Either A, she knows what's going on, and she just really wants to spend time with you before you guys start getting into your busier seasons, or B, you're not being transparent with her about your tax situation, and she thinks it's just all gravy. Now, yet again, that would be a bit of a contradiction because you said that she knows who you are, and she knows about your who you are online. So she has to know what your tax situation is, but there's no way in her right mind that she thinks that, oh, it's a good idea for him to take off a week or so with me to do shopping, to spend money, basically, knowing that the tax man's on his ass. Unless she knows this is a con and that there really isn't any tax problems and this is just a nice little way for you to come up with holiday money so you can splurge on her, to entice her into potentially moving in with you someday and being the new mate. Just saying.
So that's number one. But the other thing, folks, is that the question on everyone's mind, well, why does Phil still need this big house? Why does Phil need to stay in this house in Washington? That's beyond what he needs, you know, as a person. And he's just standing on pride that he doesn't want to lose this house that he bought. And he doesn't. No, the bottom line is, folks, that, you know, I have a girlfriend who I've been dating for months. And we're both, you know, mature adults in the point that we have our own lives, but we've been talking about our future together. We've been talking about, gee, what would we like to do? Maybe eventually, if things keep going well, we'd like to move in together. And I'm like, well, I got the perfect house for it. The problem is, I don't know if I can keep the house because of this bullshit with the taxes going on. And it fucking sucks because, really, honestly, you know, back in the summer, before the tax issue arose and we started dating, you know, things were going great.
Let me cut in for a minute, too. Why are you so desperate to move her in so badly and so quickly? You're telling me that you're telling us you want to move someone in that you barely know. That you barely know because you've only been out with her a couple times, a few times even, and you want to bring her into your home and trust her while you're sleeping. To trust her with all your bullshit. You're going to trust her that someone who knows you're about your online persona is going to keep the keys to the kingdom and not expose you. That's one of the biggest mysteries that that at least myself, I don't know about everybody else, but that here at GTG, that I've been contemplating for the longest time. Why is it that Leanna has never broken her silence and told her half the story? Why isn't it that she has not revealed the keys to Camelot? Why hasn't she exposed Galtopia yet? She's never done that. For some reason, she stayed loyal even after she left. Even up till now, with all your sneak dissing and all your bullshit, she still stayed loyal to you. And I have no clue why. You know what I mean? Anybody could do an interview with her. And not only could she profit from it, and she could gain sympathy from it. And more importantly than that, she is Pandora's box. She has everything. Anything and everything that Phil's ever done. How he feels about people. What his real financial situation is. how he really lives, which we already kind of know that, but if there's other, you know, factors into it, we don't know. She knows everything, and she never came out once and said anything. She completely wiped herself off the internet. So tell me, Phil, are you paying her to keep her silence? And if so, how much do you have to pay her? You know what I mean? I realize you've been sneak dissing her lately, and when you do, you sound more and more frustrated every time you do it. But there's obviously something that's keeping you from really going all in on her. So how much are you paying her? What is it? What does her silence actually cost? And if so, how much of it are you paying? I'm just throwing that out there. I don't know what you guys feel about that, but I've been wondering that for a little while. DSP News.
Hey, and we were like, wow, this is amazing. If this keeps going this well, maybe we can move in together and, you know, we can do all this stuff. And then boom, all of a sudden, you know, in September, October, the tax issue hits, and now it's like, now the future is completely fucking uncertain, right? It's garbage. It sucks. It fucking sucks, right? And already I see people saying silly stuff in the stream chat. Why doesn't she just move in and start helping to pay the bills? Guys, I may not be able to have this house, all right, in 2018. I'm not going to have someone move all their shit in and then have to move back out, you know? So that's the situation.
He couldn't even fake that laugh. He tried to, but he couldn't even fake it. He couldn't even fake it all the way to make it seem like a real laugh. That's funny how he says that here, though, ladies and gentlemen. But yet on Twitter, he already has his future plans laid out. Having her come in, helping with the response. This is all his wording, ladies and gentlemen. Helping with the responsibilities. Excuse me. Having a second income. These are all his words. This is exactly what he's saying on Twitter. You will see this throughout the video if you haven't seen it already. He already has it all planned in his head. She's not really meant to be anything. She's merely there to support him and take care of him. This young lady, if she exists, has no value. Nothing at all. And that in itself is something that people should be upset about. DSP News.
I'm in right now is I really have to fight as hard as I can for this house and keep it, not only for myself, all right, but for the potential future of, you know, a relationship that I've had now, you know, since the summer, and it's been going really well. And
it's only been the summer, though. You know what I mean? A summer fling isn't anything new. Now, people have pointed out that if she is real, she's just a rebound. Maybe so. But Phil is looking at this in the long term, which is stupid because he hasn't been around her long enough for that. Unless he has an ulterior motive. Ulterior motive. We'll have to wait and see. But that's why there's so much attention drawn to this, so to speak, because there's a lot wrong with it. There's a lot wrong with this.
And I want it to keep going well. But if I gotta move, right, if I have to sell this house and either get another place, or if I have to move, God forbid, I have to move back to Connecticut, that could be the end of it. See what I mean?
Yeah, God forbid that she would find someone who would actually value her and treat her right and not look at her as a living servant. God forbid, Phil, that happens. Snort.
There's even more at stake right now in regards to keeping this house than you guys have really known. Now you might be asking, well, why is Phil revealing this now? Well, ever since I revealed on Thursday about what's going on with this house and everything, and the fact that the taxes are an issue and everything, obviously there's been all these questions about why do I need the house and stuff like that. But in addition, you know, I've been talking with her every day, and she's like, you know, I feel kind of isolated, even though she, like I said, she does not want a public persona. She does not want that. She at least feels that. To know that if you guys knew that she existed, it would make more sense in the perspective, the big picture perspective, right? Because
why? Because that only makes her a target, because that means that you have ulterior motives. So we don't really. So that means people really don't know what they're giving their money to. Sorry, people don't know where their money's really going. Is it really going to help you with this house, or is it going to her? Did you guys not think this out? Like, if you guys are going to be Bonnie and Clyde about this, you have to think these things through. The illusion is always way more powerful than the reality. Did you not know? Did you not learn anything from who was it? Was it Jackie Chan, where he did the video where he had the Batman scene where he had Phil's face as Batman, and remember when Batman throws out the smoke pellets, and he's like theatrics, and I think he said theatrics and deception. He's like powerful tools to the uninitiated. But you and I are initiated, aren't we? Same shit. God damn it. This man gave you gold, Phil, and you squandered it. That's a shame. The illusion of this girlfriend is way more powerful than bringing her to the forefront. It means that if she's fake, you yourself didn't believe in your lie enough to stick with the plot. That's a shame, Phil. This is an opportunity you may never get again. And you're already fucking it up. And the more information that is out there, the more people will question it. Yeah, people are going to question it because they don't know everything, but at least for your loyal fan base, they have to take a lot of that at face value. And then the detractors are just haters if we bring up shit. But because of the fact that you're trying to give people more information to make them comfortable with the circumstances, you're fucking yourself over because now you have more to explain. And you cannot just deflect. You're going to have to give another explanation. And if it doesn't square up, you're going to have problems. That's just my opinion, though. DSP News.
Now your kind of guys are finally kind of see the big picture for the first time ever. And now it's kind of, the pieces are kind of fall into place. You know what I mean?
And what do you mean saying getting the big picture for the first time ever? You only unveiled that on Thursday. You told us about her, what, Saturday? Right? Like Saturday, I think? I don't know. You know me. I'm late. I was late when I reported on that shit. But what, like Saturday maybe is when you unveiled her? It was only 48 hours. What do you mean the big picture? No one was really, I don't think most people were even giving too much thought to that. You know what I mean? You know? I don't know. I'm just saying.
It makes sense. So now you're like, okay, I get it. So now Phil needs to keep the house because he's dating this girl who he's been seeing.
So you're saying she's a gold digger then? You're saying that, oh, well, Phil needs to keep the house because he needs to keep the girl. Because if he loses the house, he's going to lose the girl. So she's a gold digger then. I mean, let's be honest. Every woman, at least in my personal opinion, at least with my experiences, want to know that there's some type of, that the man that they're with has some type of security and some type of foundation. Something to build off of. You don't have any of that, Phil. You don't. You don't have any of that at all. Because you don't have any of that, though, you're trying to cast the illusion that you do. And that in itself is already a problem because your fan base already knows you don't. You can keep, you know, toting the line that, oh, I'm just this Let's player and I'm a decent guy, man. I've just had some bad breaks. You know, I've had some people who I've rubbed the wrong way and then they came back and shitted on me and this, that, and the third and whatever, whatever. You can say that all you want. But most women can see through bullshit. So yet again, try to make this make sense to me. To us in general. Paint the picture on how you introducing her makes all of this kind of come together and make sense. Like, by you introducing her, it's going to enact the initiative that's going to help you save your house. When in truth, Phil, she's just another mouth to feed. She's just another person to be taken care of. Even if she does contribute, now your monthly expenses are still going to go up. And I assume she's not going to go half on everything. What's she going to do, Phil? Is she going to start paying for the condo now while you pay for the house? How are you going to split the expenses up? You know what I'm saying? It's things like this. That's why you give out way too much information. You talk too goddamn much. And then when it's time for you to start really explaining shit, that's when people start getting banned. And not even the LTG get that ass banned where that shit's entertaining. It's that fucking nonchalant, passive-aggressive, you're banned. All because you are not smart enough, or you certainly are just not capable enough of seeing stuff in the long term. It's just my opinion, though.
Obviously, if he has to move, then he can't see the girl anymore. And also, if he keeps the house, then maybe eventually, you know, they could be in the move living in together, and then they could, you know, both pay for the house. See? It makes sense.
See, but listen to him, though. Even as he's spinning this narrative to you, he doesn't even sound confident in it. Like, he's scared of slipping up, which is one of the reasons why, with his Christmas Patreon goal that he apparently hit, I don't expect too much out of it, because even if he drinks, it'll be very little. Because the moment he gets saucy, and if you get the, and if the right people, if you just get people who have good timing in his chat, because he looks at the chat all the time, he may actually start answering questions and he won't be able to catch himself. Or someone could get him riled up and put him into a rant and he can't stop himself. And then that's when the information is going to come out. So if you're someone who really pays attention to Phil's bullshit, you should really be paying attention to what's going to happen on that Christmas stream. Because I guarantee you, you're going to get a little bit more out of it than what you're expecting if he really decides to drink. But even then, it's from what it sounds like, he's trying to chicken out of that too. He's slowly but surely trying to squirm his way out of that.
And that's why she kind of wanted me to talk about it today, because it now makes everything kind of formulate into a, it makes sense. And let's face it, she's kind of been a secret, and, you know, it kind of makes her feel a little bad. Because when you're kept secret, right?
Wait, she wanted anonymity. She wanted to not have an online persona or personality. So that just comes with the territory. You're supposed to be doing this, Phil, to protect her. Remember? We're not going to make the same mistakes with her as we did with the last maid. So, secret or not, this is supposed to be for her well-being. And this is supposed to be for the future or potential future of your relationship. You're taking the steps that you need to preserve that. Because Lord knows, Phil, you need to start exposing stuff about her so the wolves can sink their teeth into her too. Yet again, it's things like this that you're not thinking about that don't sound right. And that's why people question it. And if not, they should.
It kind of means like, oh, she's the dirty little secret, you know? She's not. But at the same time, we didn't want to reveal anything until we were ready. So there you go. Now, by the way, no, you're not getting her name. You're getting no information about her whatsoever. Zero. Just what I've told you right now is all you're getting. Until maybe at some time in the future, things change and maybe we're in a better position. All right? You know, maybe, just maybe.
And ladies and gentlemen, this is where myself as well as a few other people have joked, but now that I'm listening to this again, I don't think it's going to be a joke. That don't be surprised that the Patreon goal is the unveiling of her. Don't be surprised if they end up turning that into a Patreon goal. Because if I remember correctly, I think for the Metal Gear Solid Redemption run, he's asking for, what, 2K? He's asking for two stacks? $2,000. How much do you think he'll ask for to unveil her? Because don't get it wrong. Don't get it twisted, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody has a price. And Phil can justify and put a price on anybody.
Just maybe if we can get out of this situation with the house, if I can pay all these stuff, somehow find a way to pay all these taxes, all right? Then in 2018, yeah, things could be potentially much better. And maybe if she moves in with me and we start a life together, all right, then okay. If she's here living with me, and obviously, you know, you're going to see me during work hours or whatever, but of course maybe there'll be some vlogging and stuff that I start doing if she's here with me, like DSP tries it and stuff, where she's going to be in it, then it makes sense that, you know, yes, there may be more information revealed at a later date. But for now, none of that will be revealed. Nothing. People are asking me, what is her ethnicity? She's Martian. She's from the planet Mars. And that's really why I got to keep it under wraps. Because if I tell you, we'll have the government in here trying to, you know, do all kinds of Area 51 testing and shit. We can't do that, all right?
Now, excuse me. Now, what he's doing now is he's trying to insert some comedy to kind of bring the seriousness of the mood down. And it's really just a smokescreen. It's all shadow play for the most part. It's a terrible attempt, by the way.
All right, she's not Martian. All right. But that's the deal, is that, you know, I have to basically keep a lot of information to myself. And I've kept this under wraps since the summer, so I think I've done a pretty damn good job. In fact, like I said, I really had no intention of telling you guys at all about her.
Excuse me.
Until I started, you know, I revealed my whole tax situation on Thursday, you know, Thanksgiving.
Which means it was a plan.
And then, you know, all the stuff that's happened since then, and now she's like, well, it probably makes more sense to do it. So there you go. There you go, folks. That is the truth about everything that's been going on. Now you've got the bigger picture. Now I've got even more of an incentive. Now you know I have even more of an incentive, even more of a desire to fix this whole tax situation, save the house, you know, and stay where I am so that I could potentially have a much better future for myself versus moving back to Connecticut, being a solo bachelor in a piece of shit condo.
Now, here's another thing that Almighty Tevin brought up. Why move back to Connecticut? Why not just move somewhere else entirely? Just try another state. No, you don't want to do that. You only want to go where you're familiar. And that's fine, I guess. Especially at your age, I guess it's okay. But why not try somewhere else? Why not try another state? Why not try to actually have a fresh start? He's so scared of everything. He won't try anything. DSP News.
Terrible weather. You know what I mean? There you go. Snake. 8888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888888
we've laid out the scenario as best we can. Those are my thoughts as it pertains to his situation. The rest of this is just bullshit, and I'm not going to go ahead and put you guys through that. So let's go ahead and get into GTG Radio for that segment. Only be a few songs, and that'll be the end of that. I'm going to give my final thoughts. No, I'll give my final thoughts after the radio segment. All right, guys, so I'll see you guys in a few minutes.
Thank you.
I think that was befitting. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So there we go on that. An interesting situation. Could be real, could be fake. It's probably fake. But it drummed up some waves for Phil. It got people talking, which Phil needs. He needs attention in the worst way possible. If not to his dying YouTube channel, to his stream, Twitch. So either way, he can benefit from this if he plays his cards right. We'll see how long he can hold on to the narrative if he can. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking, unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG Network and Productions, sorry. As well as GTG Radio. And remember, ladies and gentlemen, the world is a very scary place, especially with people like Phil in it. Take care of yourselves. See you guys later. End of broadcast.